the fact that he believes that matters gay can be fixed with reparative therapy. In other words, he can fix, which I think to everybody on this council and in this room is about as offensive as it gets. So that alone, even that apart from the connection with Chick-fil-A, was enough for me to make this motion. Once we made a little noise, it became pretty quick that the coastal community people withdrew their sponsorship.
All right, he goes on, but you get the message. Patchy got two calls, or maybe it was one, he wasn't quite sure, from someone in the lesbian and gay community who was offended, not by the conference itself, but because a restaurant that was a sponsor had an owner who had a few years ago said he opposed gay marriage. That's what Chick-fil-A is, just like, I guess, Barack Obama opposed gay marriage until just last year, just like Hillary Clinton did until last year. Oh, and that one of the speakers, Dr. Cloud, had funny ideas about gays. Well, this just wouldn't do. I mean, the progressive counselors of Nanaimo couldn't let this stand in their city, right? Well, they have a reputation to uphold as the most progressive small town in the world. I mean, look at Patchy himself here. A weird picture of an old man posing for the cameras wearing women's shoes and some weird narcissistic selfie that apparently had some political meaning. I'm not exactly sure what, but I mean, there was no way a conference that had someone who knew someone who used to think some way that Patchy sort of knew about, but not really, but he heard about in a phone call, maybe one or maybe it was two, said was wrong. So this was an outrage. I mean, they had taken such care, this little Nanaimo counselor, to project to the world how wonderful they are. This was about them, really, not about anyone else. Here, listen to Patchy.
And I don't know about you, but for a council such as this one, which has been progressive and open-minded, on many occasions, we have unanimous decisions to fly the gay pride flag, for instance. We've done it year after year. For us to now be faced with this again is regrettable, to say the least. And so I urge you to vote in favor of this motion. It once again sends a message that I wish did not have to be sent. But here we are. I guess that's all I have to say.
So you have a city council that had flown the rainbow flag in Nanaimo, city of 80,000. They'd done the whole bit. He even posed in the girl's shoes. And now someone who knew someone who said something about someone was going to wreck the town's vibe, so they just have to be stopped. And I'll show you how they stopped them after the break. So I'm talking about the nobodies on Nanaimo's town council and how they decided to become somebodies by taking a very passionate stand about something they knew nothing about and how they showed their bigotry along the way. Hey, before I go on, have you ever in your life heard of a town of just 80,000 people videotaping their own council meetings and being such showboats? I mean, most cities of 500,000 people don't do that. I swear, I've never met such a preening, self-loving group of blowhards in my life. Being a mayor, let alone a councillor in a city of 80,000 people, isn't really a full-time job. Really, it's not. It's not even an important job. Sorry, it's just not. I mean, the RCMP handle the police, the firemen handle the fires, the province handles the hospital. It's basically roads and garbage in their convention center. But these folks, these councillors, want to show the world that they're bigger than that. They're not some backwater hicks on Vancouver Island. They're just as fashionable politically as anyone in downtown Toronto or New York. These preening, morally righteous buffoons will mug for the cameras for any reason or no reason. I mean, they recently declared a civic day called Hiroshima Day. That's how sensitive are, you see. But they're also politically correct, so they couldn't bring themselves to say whether or not they agreed with dropping the bomb on Hiroshima. They just marked the day, neither with sorrow or joy. Do you get a sense of these cowards? Or this one, this bizarreness, Intergenerational Day. It's, and I quote, meant to raise awareness about the simplicity and power of intergenerational connections in creating healthy, all-age-friendly communities. Do you get the sense that these politicians don't have a lot to do, but they sure want to make a big fuss about how important they are doing it? Seriously, I'm surprised they don't have a gluten-free awareness day, or like in that TV comedy, The Office, a rabies awareness fun run. I mean, there's a cure for rabies, but may as well raise awareness just to show how much you care. Oh, but check this one out. It says accessibility and inclusion is essential for ensuring that all community members have equity in opportunities and the ability to fully participate in community life. I need a jargon translator, but I think I understand what they're saying. But how about if you're a Christian, are you allowed to have equity and participate? Or to be more specific, if you're someone who bought a ticket to go to a show to see a conference where a company that was an advertiser knew someone who was a Christian, is that allowed in Nanaimo? No, because you see, that's offensive. That's deeply offensive. And apparently if one or two phone calls from a community are offended, then access to public buildings is limited. The whole accessibility thing I just read was just a moment to mug for the cameras. These politicians didn't mean it. Here's a bigot counselor named Diane Brennan.
When proceeding with this again, they didn't identify that Chick-fil-A was involved. I think that that's quite remarkable that they would neglect to do that. And so I'm happy to support this. I think it's unfortunate that we've had to go there, that this community has expressed its opposition to the kind of, it's not just divisive, but I think that it's summed up when we say that we don't want to be associated with organizations that promote homophobia or other expressions of hate.
Hang on a second. Homophobia? Expressions of hate? Who? Where? What? At this conference? What, Desmond Tutu maybe? Laura Bush? All those CEOs? Someone who has something to do with a restaurant that was an advertiser? That's the best you got? So how many degrees of separation is that? And what's the hateful part? Is it now homophobia and hate to have a Christian point of view? Is it deeply offensive to have a Christian point of view? Well, let's ask Nanaimo's great scholar on these matters, a student named George Anderson. Seriously, Anderson was elected to council at age 21, so he knows a lot about a lot of things. Listen.
I don't have much to add either, but I will support the motion because it goes further to say that one, that it won't have any events that are associated with organizations or people that promote divisiveness, homophobia, or other expressions of hate. And I think that goes to show that this council is showing leadership in itself by saying that we will not accept acts of hate, and it's even within our Charter of Rights and Freedoms as well that hate speech is not permitted. And so for us to go ahead and say, because it is just a leadership event, that organizations that promote hate should be able to use our facilities sends the wrong message. So I'm happy to support the motion because it's unfortunate to see this type of organization coming in and using a publicly owned, publicly funded facility. So I'm happy to support the motion.
I'm always disappointed when I encounter a bigot who's black, just like when I encounter a bigot who's a Jew or a bigot who's gay. I keep thinking, don't you get it? If you bully your political opponents, if you discriminate against people you disagree with, you violate the entire ethos of civil rights. That is, equality before the law and tolerance for other views. Again, I ask, what acts of hate is he talking about? Was Laura Bush going to do something crazy for the first time in her life? Did Anderson there and the other counselors have some secret knowledge that no one else in the world, the other 800 places that were having this simulcast, didn't know? Of course not. They were just trying to outdo each other as to who could be more politically correct than the last one, who could be more media savvy, more fashionable, mugging for the cameras of this tiny town of 80,000 people with their televised city council meetings. Maybe if they look great enough, they could be picked up for some reality TV show. The Intergenerational Connections Proclamation didn't do it, so maybe this was their ticket out of their small town and to Hollywood. Now, I'm sure I have a lot to learn from a 21-year-old ignoramus. This is his first real job. I'm not going to lord it over him and say that I have a law degree and that I've studied constitutional law, because you don't need to be a lawyer to simply read the Constitution. A 21-year-old can read it just fine. A high school student can read it just fine. That bigot has never read our charter. Take a look. I mean, the very first line in the Charter is, whereas Canada is founded upon principles that recognize the supremacy of God and the rule of law. Sorry, you're not a member of an organized criminal group to say that. These councillors have actually violated both parts of that preamble, haven't they? They violated the respect for religion and the rule of law. I mean, they want to drive Christians out of town without any due process. Here, let me read for Anderson, and I know it's probably for the first time he's heard this. Let me read the section of our Charter.